Welcome back to Power Lunch. The big thing that we are focusing right now is the primary article inflation figure, which has come out along with food article inflation. None of it which is looking comfortable at all. Actually, it could just play the big spoil spot in the India growth story. You've got a primary article food inflation figure for December 25th inching close to a record high of 20.2% and food inflation also over 17%, which is up 2.5% week on week. It also impacts the FMCG companies because raw material prices go up, margins get impacted. We've got Sunil Duggal, Chief Executive Officer of Dabur India Limited. Sunil, I have lots to talk to you about along with your completion of acquisition of Namaste. But, you know, everybody is so worried about the food inflation figures and primary article inflation figures which have come out today. What's your own reaction? I mean, the markets haven't taken that news very well when it comes to your sector overall. It's down about 1.5% sectoral index. You think margins will get impacted if this is not controlled?
Well, inflation remains a concern and it doesn't seem to be leveling off in some articles, but it's not broadbanded. So we're seeing pockets of very high inflation, let's say in coconut oils, few plastics, etc. But there are pockets where the price is pretty much under control, say raw honey and sugar, etc. So it's a mixed bag, but it remains an area of concern. We were hoping to see a sharp leveling off of inflation. That is not happening. So there is some impact on margins, but it is not yet serious. And we believe it will be mitigated by some price increases, which we are going to take in the next few weeks.
I will come, of course, to the core business. But is that a big risk you see overall? The fact that it also leaves much lesser money in the pocket of the consumer, the discretionary spends go down.
Well, having said that, I think our price increases will be well below the rate of inflation. We are looking at price increases of the region of perhaps 4% for the full year, which is one half or one third the rate of inflation. So I don't think the consumer has any reason to crib about the price increases. They still will be protective of the consumer interest, and I don't think it would in any way impact demand. There is still high growth in disposables, and the inflation is largely in the area of food and not in consumer staples. So I don't see that as being a cause of worry.
Fair enough, Sunil. Good to get your view on that. So let's focus on the big completion of the Namaste acquisition. Just run us through your estimates on revenues, both from Hobi as well as Namaste. When does it get reflected in your financial performance?
Well, Hobi started getting reflected in the third quarter, which has just been completed. And Namaste consolidation will happen from the 1st of January. So we'll see the fourth quarter as being fully consolidated with both these entities.
Also, if you look at the trend which has been in the last three quarters, your international businesses seem to be growing at a much faster pace, clipping ahead. Domestic growth is there, but more subdued. Is that a trend that you see continuing? Can you run us through both the positives of domestic businesses and, of course, international businesses?
Well, the domestic business continues a fairly steady trajectory. The international business has been going much ahead because there's often lower base and there's an expansion in terms of geographies, which obviously is not there in as far as the domestic market goes. I think the overseas would continue to be ahead of domestic in terms of the growth rates for the next couple of years at least. And then when it reaches a certain critical mass, then the growth should be pretty much similar to that of the domestic market. However, the overseas business will always be augmented by M&A activity, as we have seen in the past, and there are more possibilities of this non-linear growth happening overseas rather than in India.
You're sitting on a wide product portfolio and you're acquiring more businesses as well. What would the focus be in 2011?
On all our categories, HPC, healthcare, as well as food, the focus would be everywhere, and we will see growth from both our existing portfolios as well as existing and new geographies. What we probably will not add is a fresh line of businesses to our existing portfolio, because we believe that we are pretty much covered across the businesses which we want to enter.
So then are you ruling out any further acquisitions in 2011 and saying that this is the year that you will look at consolidating the two businesses you've acquired in US and Turkey?
Not at all. I think we do have the bandwidth to acquire more companies. The focus certainly would be on consolidation, but once we are satisfied that the businesses have been fully consolidated, we would seek fresh targets to acquire. Our appetite is still there, and we believe that we can still do more. I wouldn't rule out another acquisition happening in 2011.
You've already talked about the price hikes, that there's one imminent around the corner, but it won't be high enough to actually impact demand. But can you run us through the growth picture which is emerging in the coming quarter and then the subsequent quarters of 2011? What are the internal targets that you're building for growth?
I think we can look at growth in the mid-teens. That seems to be a reasonable estimate. And that is the kind of, in terms of organic growth, of course. And we believe we can achieve that level of growth in the next few quarters.
So that's pretty similar.
It will, again, be largely driven by volume. Sorry, yes, it is pretty similar, yes.
To Q2 profits, and you know, growth there was about 14.3% or so. Is that the trend that we'll also see in the profitability?
Perhaps the profitability would lag a little bit in the short term over top line because of the inflationary impact. And when that has leveled off, or when the price increases have caught up with the raw material inflation, we would see the bottom line mirroring the top line, which would probably be from the first quarter of next year. At the moment, there could be a little bit of drag in terms of margins for the last two quarters of the year.
So where do you think the average margins for 2010-11 end in the next two quarters? And if you see the picture improving, what would you set as internal targets for the next fiscal year?
We would seek to maintain the EBITDAs at the 18 to 20% band, which that's what they are today, and seek very aggressive top-line growth. I think that's a very satisfactory business model which we want to emulate. So 18 to 20% EBITDA margin is what we believe is the right band for us.
All right, Sunil. So it's looking like business is on track with a little bit of squeeze on margins because of inflation. Good day to have you with us and get your perspective on all that's happening with Dabur and, of course, also on inflation and how that impacts your business. Thank you so much for joining us here on Power Lunch.